on the Facebook. And leader over to our new moderator, Phil Dodd, as we all can recognize Phil.
Thanks for coming. First, if everyone please stand, we'll do the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Just a couple things before we get started. First off, yeah, this is my first meeting as moderator, although if anyone knows me, I've joked for a long time that I'd be moderator when I was sitting over there. So I'm holding myself at high standard, but I'm still sure I'll screw up as we're going along. But I'd just like to recognize Valerie Osmond, our previous moderator. It's not an easy job, and I know I saw Valerie somewhere here, so Valerie, where are you? Oh, there you are, yeah. So thank you, Valerie. That's good morning, Valerie. I ran into Valerie at Market Basket in the spring, and it just was one of those things. I go to Market Basket pretty regularly, but this was a different time for me. And I ran into Valerie, and, you know, how you doing, whatever. And she said, I'm not running for moderator. I said, you aren't. I said, well, I'll run. I said, I wouldn't have ever run against you, but if you're not running, I'll do it. So again, thank you, Valerie. And again, before we go on just a few introductions, we have on our finance committee, we have Bill Cook, who's the chairman, correct? We have Andy Wild, not looking at some of this, but Leanne Berry, Kathy Delisle, and Bill O'Neill. So on left, we have our town clerk, Ann Brody, and town council attorney Bill Hewig, our finance director Denise Nemkowski, chairman of board of selectmen Bill Dunn, board of selectmen member Joe DeMore, Ed Watson, and Dan McDonald. I think we have a comment somewhere to Jackie Sullivan. Sorry, somewhere. She's here now.
On the stage.
Oh, okay. Oh, and that reminds me, if we have any visitors that aren't registered voters, they need to be on the stage. Just again, a couple of things before we actually get started. There's I don't have a lot of housekeeping rules, but my big thing is I want people to be heard. I want you to speak, at least initially. I mean, I have my timer here, and I can certainly get it going. But if somebody has something new to say, that's great, and we want to hear it. What we don't want to hear is the same thing over and over. I mean, if you've got something new, we definitely want to present it. I've asked the powers that be up here, I'm asking people in the audience, that we make a motion as a positive motion, whether people are in favor or not. Just we'll move favorable action, second, and then the people who are against it can certainly speak against it, people for it can speak for it, and then yes will mean yes and no will mean no.
Good call.
Yeah. As far as discussing reading the article, I'm fine with reading. If people don't want to hear me read, that's fine. We don't have a big warrant tonight, so wherever we want to go. So from there, I'd just like to turn it over to our town clerk.
Thank you, Bill. To Robert J. Mellowitz, Chief of Police in the Town of Groveland in the County of Essex, greetings. In the name of the Commonwealth, you are hereby required to notify and warn the inhabitants of said town who are qualified to vote in a special town meeting to meet at the Dr. Elmer S. Bagnell School, 253 School Street on Monday, October 26, 2015 at 7 p.m. to vote on the following articles.
Okay, here we go. Article 1. To see if the town will vote to transfer the sum of $195,000 from the overlay surplus account for the purpose of funding the town's operating budget for FY16 or take any other action relative thereto. Board of Selectmen recommends.
Favorable.
Finance Board recommends.
Favorable action.
We have a motion and a second.
Move favorable action.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second for favorable action. So now we're open for discussion. Do we have any discussion? Seeing none, we have motion and second, so all those in favor, Article 1 passing, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no. Unanimous, passes. Article 2, to see if the town will vote to appropriate an additional sum of $30,000 from the Pines Boat Rent Revolving Fund, over the amount authorized by the annual town meeting, Article 14, on April 27, there's a typo here, it says 2014, but it's actually 2015, to meet additional expenses due to renovation work or take any other action relative thereto. Board of Selectmen recommend?
Favorable.
Finance Board recommends?
Favorable action.
We have a motion and a second.
Second.
We have a motion and a second for favorable action, so now we can open it for discussion. Any discussion? And just one other thing, as we can see, that just when you walk up to the mic, state your name and where you live and speak.
How many years have
you been? Right, yeah, and speak right into the microphone. Thank you.
Technologist, 35 Union Street. Just a quick question. The $30,000, I'm wondering if this is an extra. Could you describe the extras? If it's not an extra, why was this not part of the original bid?
So the proposal for renovating the boat ramp in total was $173,000. We are asking to take $30,000 from the boat ramp revolving fund, which people pay each year to use that boat ramp, and then the remaining $143,000 is part of Article 5 with the community preservation money. So a total of $173,000 for the boat ramp, that's with us doing it in-house. $143,000 is part of the CPC proposal.
Any other discussion? All right, seeing none, we'll move to question. All those in favor of Article 3, I'm sorry, Article 2, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Say no.
No.
Majority, yes. Passes. Article 3, to see if the town will vote to make the following transfers or take any other action relative thereto. $3,000 from building inspector, salary line item number, I won't read the line number if that's okay. To building expense line item to cover initial funding shortfall. $3,000 from administrative assistant salary line item to selectman expense line item to cover initial funding shortfall. $1,200 from custodian facilities line item to facility supplies line item to cover initial funding shortfall. $3,000 from legal expenses line item to police expense line item to cover expenses related to construction of a firing range. And $10,000 from library director salary line item to $5,000 to libraries, staff wages line item, and $5,000 part-time wages line item to cover initial funding shortfall. Board of Selectmen recommend?
Favorable.
Finance Board recommends?
Favorable action.
Move favorable action.
Second.
We have a motion and second. Is there any discussion?
I have an amendment.
Okay.
Do you want to read it?
Yes, we can.
Okay. So I'd like to amend the fourth item on the list, $3,000 from legal expenses line. Oh, I'm sorry. Mike Dempsey.
Yeah, as I said, I know we are.
$3,000 from legal expenses line item, police expense line item, cover expenses related to construction of a firing range, pending issuance of a required review and permit by the Commonwealth of Mass Natural Heritage and Endangered Species Program. This is the reason why I'm offering this amendment is that I mentioned this to the selectmen and the police when this first came up, and I want to make sure that we do get a permit from Natural Heritage, because if not, we're risking some of the future things that we might want to do there. Because they do have purview over most of the site there.
Okay, so before we have discussion on the amendment that's been offered, we need a motion for favorable action on the amendment. Does someone want to make that motion?
So moved.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Okay, so we can have discussion on the amendment. Any discussion?
The Congress, 35 Union Street. Another quick question. Are these personal economic hits? In other words, are we literally taking money out of people's salaries? Is that actually happening?
No, so the first three items were all mid-year hires. So because we had some staff where we didn't, or we've had some changes in the personnel, We added the money to the expense line so that they could get their first year expenses.
So this has no personal impact on a single employee in the town of Groveland?
That is correct.
Thank you.
Any other discussion? Okay. So we were going to vote the amendment first, okay? And in case you didn't quite catch it, it's just the very end of that that says any issuance of required review of permit by the Commonwealth of Mass National Heritage Endangered Species Program. So that's how we changed that particular article. So all those in favor of the amendment to Article 3 say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
No.
Okay, a majority yes on the amendment. So now, any other discussion on the article as amended? Okay, seeing that, we're going to take a vote on the article as amended. So all those in favor of Article 3, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no.
No.
Majority, yes, it passes to as amended. Okay, on to Article 4. To see if the town will vote transfer the sum of $98,000 from the Badland Summer Revolving Account to Badland Landscape and Grounds Account or take any other action relative thereto. Board of Selectmen recommend.
Favorable action.
Finance Board recommends.
Favorable action.
Move favorable action.
Second.
And we have a motion and a second for favorable action. Any discussion?
Technology is still residing at 35 units. The Bagnell Landscape and Grounds account, I'm assuming that's a new one because for over four decades it's been just, I mean, it was so bad when we were doing a baseball back that it was just beyond awful. However, $98,000 from what? What are we subtracting $98,000 from? What is that figure?
Denise, could you answer that?
That is the summer recreation program, so the monies that parents pay to send their kids to the Bagnell Recreation Program that's held here at this facility. There's excess funds in that account.
No, I'm looking for the, we're subtracting 98,000 from a mathematical figure. What is that mathematical figure?
$102,978.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Over here.
Kim Jackson, 10 Park Street. What is the $98,000 going to be used for?
Okay. Number one, I met with the superintendent of schools, the principal, the summer program director, the finance director. So we had a meeting, and the purpose I had for this meeting was to get everybody's wish list and try to find out what everyone wanted, what they needed for that project. As everyone has stayed in the town, the fields have been a mess. It's been 35 years. It's been well needed repair. So what we're going to end up with, hopefully, is we're going to end up with a new sprinkler system with a well. The well is going to go into a bunker in the ground, and the electricity will come from the school. And it will be 100% self-supporting for the fields. Number two, we're going to renovate the two ball fields that are out there with an infield clay mix complete. There won't be any sod, it'll be a complete infield mix ball field, which will be taken care of from the funds. They ask for kiosks as they bring the children around the back of the school. They want to have the matrons, whatever you call them, out of the weather. They call the kids in and out of school now because of the new format of how the schools got locked down. So in that kiosk, we're going to give them power on the backside of the kiosk, which will then give the summer program power, which will then take it and be isolated somewhat away from the school.
Electric power.
Then in the wish list was a tree shade garden. So it'll be 6-inch caliber trees that will be installed. Under the trees will be bark mulch, wood chips for the kids. They can have their picnic tables and what have you. It'll be 12 inches thick. And then it'll be a heavy shaded area, and then the trees will kind of thin out toward the other areas to help keep the lawns going. And like I said, the reason that I truly feel this is a very important program is because we really need to get the back of that school looking like the front of the school and what the building program and the building committee did. And I did get a commitment from our highway commissioner. He will maintain this project if it goes the way that we have got this proposal before us. He's committed to take care of that 100% with the highway department as far as mowing and what have you. So I think I've got all the issues answered, hopefully.
About a month ago, the soccer league and the back to school building committee presented a program to put out two athletic fields, the well, and a pavilion. And then there was an alternate presentation for repairing the fields, the well, and a pole barn to act as a pavilion. Has that been changed?
They're not going to have a pole barn. It wasn't in their wish list. They decided not to do it.
Okay. The other thing is there going to be a tap for to support the garden group?
Yes, there is.
Okay, because right now they're coming off of school water before paying sewer on.
Yes, it will be taken care of and it will be self-supporting for gardens.
Hi, Julie Schubert, 13 Wood Street. How about the playground? I'm hearing a lot about the fields. What about the playground?
There was nothing in the proposal for the playground.
Okay, so my thought is, okay, the field's great. It's going to bring in all the sports teams and everything. But what about the, you know, for the kids that go to school there? So how do we address that?
Well, I would need, number one, to realize what the playground needs, but this proposal is to get the grass back for the children. And the summer program wanted the ball fields, because we asked them if they want to scrap them, keep them. They wanted them for the ball fields. And I don't know of anyone that's come forward to use the ball fields other than the summer program and the school. So there was no talk about the hot top play area. I would love to see, me personally, I would love to see the playground equipment, not the swing set, but the playground equipment from Washington Park maybe moved over. But again, as we stated a minute ago, the $58,000 in the proposal was scrapped. So, you know, I don't want to make promises I can't keep, but at 103, I do believe we need extra money to do what we need to do over there. But I think we're going to be good.
So you're saying you think there's extra money for the playground?
Yes, because this proposal at 103 was put in before I met with the superintendent and all the people. And in the meeting, they decided to scrap the pavilion, which was a biggest chunk of the, a good chunk of the budget.
Okay, because I know that we've heard in the past that there was going to be renovations with the playground, the basketball net, and all that stuff. There's supposed to be some plan about that whole area that's up high, the whole area there. And then, I don't know what happened.
Well, I can tell you in our meeting it wasn't brought up, no one brought it up, no one discussed it. So if we can maybe get a committee down the road or some people together and, you know, come before us, I'd be glad to address any problems we have with it.
Okay, thank you.
Jim Day, 2 Cottles Ferry Lane. Just two quick questions. One, first question is about the drainage system and the septic and the manholes that are in the field that the kids will be playing over. Is there any plan to take those things out so the kids would not hurt themselves in those areas?
Yes, it's all going to be scrapped. It's going to be filled in and scrapped. There's two catch basins out there right now, and there's an old septic system that will be taken care of. There's a drainage manhole out there right now which will end up having to be graded to get the water to go into it.
And the second question is just before putting this money to put these nice fields in, I know the summer camp for my kid, my oldest child going there, they played on that field with bouncy houses, water slides and stuff that would kill the grass. Is there a plan to have an area for them to put that stuff?
As I stated before, there's going to be a shade garden with wood chips. So again, as we get to the nitty gritty, what we would do is we'd lay an area out working with the different committees and programs and what have you, and you tell us what you need and we'd lay that out. But yes, I could definitely, that would be a big deal.
Okay, any other discussion? Seeing none, let's take a vote. All those in favorable action on Article 4 say aye.
Aye.
Opposed say no.
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 I say that's a majority yes. And it passes. On to Article 5. To see if the town will vote to appropriate a sum of up to $360,000 from the Community Preservation General Reserve Fund FY 2016 to be made available for the purpose of revitalization of recreational resources at the Pines Recreation Area, including a new boat ramp, one softball field, utility field, and two tennis courts. The project is to be managed by the Town Finance Director and the Conservation Commission under the CPA category Recreation and be completed no later than June 30th, 2019 for or take any other action relative thereto. The article submitted by the Committee for Preservation Committee and the Board of Selectmen. The Board of Selectmen, Board of Selectmen recommends.
Favorable action.
Finance Board recommends.
Favorable action.
Move favorable action.
Second.
We have a motion and a second for favorable action. Any discussion?
For this meeting with the Board of Selectmen, I understand that the two tennis courts are not to be included in this.
The number that was submitted prior to tonight, the number had grown over 360. So I'll back up a step now that I'm talking. We have met with the different committees and different groups. The ball field is a needed thing for the girls softball, etc. The boat ramp is a very needed thing. My take on this is, if this does not pass tonight, and I'm not trying to threaten people, I'm just trying to be honest, if we go down the road we're going right now, that project will have zero money in probably 3 to 4 years, because if we finish the project with the money that's in that account now, we're going to drain the money to nothing. There'll be no money to maintain it. And I don't mean maintaining the grass that the highway department does. I mean maintaining the lights, the water, the fertilizing, and the sprinkler repair, and et cetera, et cetera. There's going to be no money there. And what we don't have in the town of Roland right now is we really don't have a good take on our infrastructure, our parks. We don't have money set aside. We don't have a number in our town budget. So that's what's scaring me about it. And again, yes, we're going to probably have to ax out the tennis courts and the lighting, because I don't want to go over the 360. I'd like to keep it at the 360, get the ball field, keep the boat ramp, and do what we can do for that number. But we're going to have to cut some of it, because the number came in higher than it was. So I can tell you this, me as the chairman of the board, I will re-enter it again in the spring, and I will put the tennis court or whatever they're axing out, and I'll try it again in the spring for you people, but I can't get that number in there tonight, I just can't.
Before we point, just a second. So what I'm hearing is that nobody wants the tennis courts included. Is that correct? So
what I'm saying is, it's not what no one. I'm
sure. No, I understand. For tonight, for our yes. So if that's what we intend to vote on, then we should remove that from the article. So.
Can I?
Sure. Go ahead.
Mike Hogan, one mail, Tom Rowe. So what happened here is
Mike, please.
So what had happened here is we had proposed a figure, and we were asked at the last minute to come down because the number that we proposed was above the warrant article amount, with that combined with the boat ramp. So what we as a committee, so that only happened on over the weekend, so we haven't had a chance to meet yet, but our intent is to keep the tennis courts and to revise the proposal to utilize a different water approach than we were looking to do to water the fields. We'd like to try to make down the Pines, as everyone's stirring down, there's been some big improvements down the Pines, but we're still not at a point where it needs to be. We've got flattened areas that can be fields, and so our intent is we want to get those built out. So the Recreation Committee has stepped forward to say we asked for this funding to do that, and the intent is for us to build out the softball field, and then water that as well as the utility field that's put down there in the back corner. And then to put the two tennis courts in when you first come in where that flattened area is that's gravel now. That's our intent. Now clearly we have to go out to bid to make sure we can do all that within that, but our intent is to keep the tennis courts and not cut those out. Is that the question?
Mike, you might want to add that we're coming back to lighting them.
Right, so because we had made the changes, the original discussion we had was to put lighting in. So this, the work we're proposing does not complete all the Pines project. We want to be clear on that. So if there were to be additional changes, that would have to happen at a later time, i.e. lights for the fields, or to provide different elements down there that aren't finished out of the original plan that was created.
Any other discussion?
So, when do you anticipate beginning construction on any of this?
So our intent would be to start as soon as we completely get approval, and then once we get approval, we're going to go bid for it. We'd like to get some of the work done before the ground freezes. Not only we can't grass the road this time of year, but we can't get some of the work done if we could get approval. If not, then it'll be early spring.
Any other discussion?
Yes.
Sorry, didn't see you. Go ahead over here first.
Chuck Harris, Lot 94 Main Street. Just trying to get some clarity to the detail on some of this. You mentioned there was a money allocated for the boat ramp. Is it 170?
173
is the total. So 173. So the 30,000 that's being allocated is coming and being taken off that 173. So it's leaving you with 143?
143 comes under Article 5, yes.
So 143 of the boat ramp is under Article 5. And so as far as the boat ramp goes, I mean, is that allowed to be used by anybody or just members of Groveland?
Just Groveland.
Well, once
how's that managed? Yeah. How do you prevent it?
I have a key. I'm using a key since 1997 to get in the gate.
So anybody would have to get the key how?
I pay $25 a year. They give me a key and I unlock it. Boat goes in, we go down the river, we come back, boat goes out, and I lock it each time in and out.
Okay, so how many members now out of Groveland have a key?
Don't know.
Does anybody know that, Steve?
Denise, go ahead.
So just one quick thing. Once community preservation money is used on that facility, it can no longer be restricted to Groveland residents. So if we do put community preservation money anywhere into the Pines, it now would become open to the general public.
Exactly. So we have fields down there. Too.
That
so
is correct.
Isn't safety a concern of anybody with kids running around down there and people flying around in boats? I mean, to me, it is. I mean, my kids don't play sports, but they do use the Pines. It's one of the areas we probably use the most in Groveland. It's usually dead on the weekend, actually. But, it's a concern. And I don't think it should be included in this. I think it should be separated out. People should be allowed to vote on it separately. I think we should separate, have two articles, and have one saying $143,000 if it's the CPA and the rest for the balance, if that's what we want to do. I just think nobody is really thinking this through, I think. I understand it's a great thing. A lot of people want to use it personally, and people have broken, but like you say, we're using CPA funds for it now. So it's going to be open to anybody. All right, people can come across and use it. West Newbury could come down. Anybody can use this program now and have access to a key. These are families now, actually. So. There's got to be some way to really think this through. I just don't think it's being thought through.
Well, I can say one thing that anyone that's going to use that boat ramp is still going to need to get a key to use the boat ramp. So it's not going to be, I don't think, like mayhem or whatever. But I agree.
You have a limit? I mean, we're going to be allowed to be limited? Is there any rules that allow?
No, I can tell you since I've worked here, only 5 out of town people have requested access to that boat ramp. So we have about 100 boaters in town. And 5 people have requested to use it, so.
Over here.
Jim Jackson, Park Street. Years ago, when the program was initially started, it was 2 separate items. The boat ramp was its own entity, and the Pine was its own entity. So now you're combining the two. Into one entity, and then there was separate accounts for monies for the boat ramp and to maintain that particular property, and then there was the other monies for the Pines, which were generated by the removal of sand by the contractor over a period of 3 or 4 years, and then the finishing. So is now everything, how can it be all grouped together? Or is it, it's still the boat ramp and the Pines? I need clarity on that, please.
Anyone answer that question?
So I believe we would still maintain the boat ramp revolving because people do pay to use that on an annual basis. Regarding the Pines account, money that's come in over the years has been spent on engineering and work for the boat ramp. The boat ramp revolving fund has really been for smaller light bulb changes, keys, things like that. It hasn't been used for any major infrastructure. I don't believe there's any plans to consolidate that into one whole plan. This one article was consolidated because if I may speak for the board, they were trying to get everyone's project done. So they wanted to have one project, one article to get both interests of the boat ramp and the recreation combined to go forward. They didn't want to pit one project against another because they wanted to see everything go forward.
Okay, I understand that. I also understand that there was supposed to be bathroom facilities done down there. That's not listed in this article.
No, so we are still looking at bathrooms. We have some prospects in place for doing most of the work in-house that would come out of the remainder of the Pines account. We still have money in that account that we're looking to use money for the street lighting, lining the roadway, and putting in the bathrooms.
Just a personal opinion, although my kids are grown and gone, that the bathroom facilities would be the more priority subject to taking care of the youth and adults that use the existing facilities.
I think the bathrooms are looked at more as infrastructure. So the Pines account itself has been used for the infrastructure, the underground utilities, the bathrooms, things like that. The community preservation, they were looking more at fields and boat ramps and recreational items, not so much the bathrooms. So it is still part of the plan. We're actually hoping to start working on them in the next few weeks.
Okay, Steve, we have some more discussion. And I'll get to you guys again. Just let's go over here. Somebody has this over here.
Andrew Cox, 11 Wilbert Ave. I just believe $170,000 total for the boat ramp for 100 people, with $1,700 per boater. Other people that don't have boats shouldn't have to take care of the people with boats. And then also there was a concern of the field maintenance, the watering, the fertilizer, and things like that, and saying that that hasn't been covered or addressed, yet we're building more fields. So to me, it doesn't make sense. If we can't take care of what we have, why do we need more?
Essentially, I think these are questions for 5A and 5B, and like you mentioned, say that really what you're saying is that you'd like to see the sum of $237,000 go to a softball field and utility field, period. From what I heard from all the scale out here, right? Yeah. No tennis courts, right? You killed them. They're not in the press, right? Because if you have 237, then 143 is going towards the boat ramp out of the 360, right? So you have 143 that's the boat ramp. Right. So out of that 360, you're just left with 237.
Correct.
And that 237 is for a softball field and a utility field.
And four tennis courts.
So this would be tennis courts as well. So 237 for a softball field, utility field, and two tennis courts. And then Article 5B would be to see the sum of $140,000 go to a new boat ramp.
All right, so you guys
see if people can, we're rolling things in when clearly there's some people that don't.
You're tested with the moderator. Okay, 18 years in the Board of Selectmen, we never had a motion to divide a question, but you can divide the question. Okay,
make a motion to divide the question.
Let me just ask a question, Tom. Repeat it one more time, just so we can make sure we get clear.
So 5A, making a motion to divide the question. 5A would be to see if the town will vote to appropriate a sum of up to $237,000 from the Community Preservation General Reserve for year 2016 to be made available for the purpose of the revitalization of recreational resources at the Pines Recreation Area, to include one softball field, a utility field, and two tennis courts. The project is to be managed by the Town Finance Director and the Conservation Commission under the CPA category of recreation and be completed no later than June 30, 2019. And then 5A would be to see if the town will vote to appropriate a sum of $143,000 from the Community Preservation General Reserve for year 2016 to be made available for the purpose of revitalization of the recreational resources at the Pines Recreation Area for the new boat ramp. And that project is managed by the Town Finance Director and the Conservation Commission.
So just one quick question, Bill. So we have a motion to split into those two parts. So the first vote would be actually to split it, and then we would take a separate vote. Okay, so we're gonna vote on that motion. Oh, actually, we just have a motion. Do we have a second on that?
Second.
Do we want to have discussion and splitting it?
Yes.
Okay.
I think his figure is wrong. I think it's $217,000.
Thank you.
Appreciate that. Yep, it's $217,000. You're absolutely right.
Okay, secondly, my first question that was never answered by Selectman Dunn was, I was told an hour ago that we weren't going to include the two tennis courts because we did not have enough money in the 360. So something's got to give.
I think it was answered by my colleague. He said that they had met, but I guess that information hadn't been conveyed to the Board of Selectmen.
Oh, I'm sorry. If I'm... Did I misinterpret?
No, what Bill said is correct. So when we were told over the weekend that we couldn't provide the warrant today what the amount we had paid for, so we were asked to make some cuts. It was suggested that the tennis courts had taken out. And our proposal, our discussion we had informally, was that we want to keep the tennis courts in and instead change the approach we're taking for watering fields to reduce that amount on that and then not on by taking out the tennis
courts. What would the tennis courts cost us?
It's that we've gotten so far in between $75,000 and $80,000.
So you can adjust the other things by $75,000?
Correct. It's not costing. That's our intent.
Other discussion? Sorry, Dan.
Are we still discussing Article 5?
Yes, we're talking, we're discussing splitting it into two.
I would actually like every single thing on here. I'd also like to be the captain of a 120-foot yacht. Instead, I can only afford an 18-and-a-half-foot Larson. I've been going in and out of the boat ramp since 1997. I would think that the one thing on here, and I agree with you about the safety, I also agree with this other gentleman that you shouldn't have to be paying a dime for whatever I can afford or not afford. I would think that the boat ramp, unless you could really convince me that this was, I don't know why it has to be stiffy, it's just unlock the lock, open the gate, bring the boat in, launch, go, have a nice sunset, come back, and go in and out. It's that simple. I would also remind us that 2 years ago, we fallaciously, with a lack of information, this night, we wouldn't even have to show up. We paid $3.7 million for a piece of property here in town that was assessed for $900,000. That would have paid for all of this and then some. My final, that's a statement. My question here is, can you define the word manage? This is a recreation area. I'm not aware that anyone on the conservation team or the finance director has in their resume experience with recreation. Or when it says manage, are we talking about managing that financially?
Joe?
Just a couple of items I'd like to share with the public. I have a spreadsheet here, and it's a public document. We'll make it available to anybody. But back in 2006, we added 122 and change thousand as a rollover balance, which became part of a revenue line that began to increase over time. And in particular, in FY10, FY11, FY12, 13, 14, 15 is basically where we brought in most of the money from the sale of the aggregates of the pines. So that brought in a total amount of money of $951,000 and change, $951,945 if you want to make the exact amount. Now I have 11 pages here of expenditures that have been occurring since fiscal year 2006. And part of those expenditures includes some of the decisions that have been made by previous leadership, which I agree with, that there should have been a boat ramp. The boat ramp did not materialize suddenly overnight. But boat ramp has been something that has been voted on several times over, and it has been supported by funding. Now, I did a little bit of a check, and inside these sheets of paper, we have already spent $59,000 for engineering studies and infrastructure for a new boat ramp. That's not a decision of this board only, it's an accumulation of decisions that have been done over the years, of which I absolutely was in favor of. So, whether we have the boat ramp segregated in its own article or we have it included, the boat ramp is, again, not anything that came out of thin air, it's something that had been voted on over the years and have been supported. So now if we don't pursue the boat ramp, we will blow $59,000, and then I don't know how much money we're going to have to spend to do something with the existing boat ramp, which is in serious disrepair. So we need to be very thoughtful about what we're doing. If we're going to shut down the boat ramp, so be it. But keep in mind that there were some very good decisions that were done by other boards, Board of Selectmen specifically, which I support. And those decisions were made with a lot of good thought, in my opinion, and that's just an opinion, First Amendment rights. So we want to be very thoughtful. Now, if you take $951,000 of revenue that was brought in since fiscal year 2006, which includes that rollover balance of $122,000, we've spent $691,000.
Discussion with regards to splitting the motion.
Yeah. You're right. I understand what you're saying. I've seen that too. It is discussion. Yeah. We're going to move that question.
When we come to the point of the boat ramp being split out, I mean, I think it's an appropriate thing.
People have been speaking, it's my opinion, and town council, correct me if I'm wrong, but it's all part of why we should split this motion or not. Okay. Yeah, I agree. This might be redundant. We might hear it again, but is that okay?
So, what Bill had mentioned earlier is we have a balance here of $260,000, and now we can conveniently use, if it's the pleasure of this town to do so, CPA money, to basically complete this project, which includes the boat ramp. So if you want to split it, split it. But I think we should maintain that boat ramp in this plan. And I would go on record that I would not support the idea of splitting it.
Dan, just a second. Okay. Right over here, Dan.
Kevin, Seven Harbor Road. Just to clarify this, when community preservation met last week on these two important issues, they were presented as two separate issues, and we voted separately on each issue. That hasn't been reflected yet because the minutes haven't been presented, but that's how it was voted by community preservation. Not necessarily. There was full support for the panels, and then it was agreed to bring the vote ramp before the town meeting. It wasn't a positive. We didn't take a vote on who supported it. I don't believe, did we pay any money? We didn't take a vote on whether we supported it as a board to spend that money, but that it should be brought before the town. It's two separate issues. That's how it was voted.
Thank you.
Not one more.
So, McDonald, did you want to add something before we vote?
I did. I support the boat ramp. Here's the deal. CPA money, Conservation Preservation Act money, is available. There's approximately $1.6 million in that account. About half of that is restricted for statutory required spending. There's another $800,000, I think it was $817,000 last I looked at it, that is not specifically required to be used for historical affordable housing or open space. So there's over $800,000 in the existing account under the CPA funds that is available for recreational use. So I don't think that we need to pit one project against the other. The funds are available. So I've asked myself the question, and whether or not I support this. If we do not spend it on leaving the Pines recreation area, and I see it as one thing, I see it as the ramp's already at the Pines. Whether you want to separate that or not, it's there. It's connected. So as far as bifurcating this, you have to drive through the Pines to get to the boat ramp. This is Groveland. We're on the banks of the Merrimack River. I think it's a great, great part of this town. I think we ought to be proud of that. Maybe more people would go if you built the ramp. Maybe they would come. Maybe they wouldn't. But despite that, it's all coming out of the same pot, which is CPA funds, and there's $800,000. If you don't spend it on the boat ramp, you might spend it on affordable housing. You might buy more land. So finish what we started. Otherwise, you're just going to waste $50,000. Army Corps of Engineers has a jurisdiction over that waterway because it comes under federal jurisdiction. Those are not easy permits to pull. If you close off that, and there was some argument, the highway commissioner was saying that it could get washed away. It's just going to cost more money down the road. So you pay now, or you pay later. There's only two kinds of maintenance, people. There's maintenance and there's deferred maintenance. You can procrastinate it all you want, but it's not going to go away. And in terms of keeping this together, up close, it's all part of the Pines. There is only one Pines recreation area, and the boat ramp's already there.
Move the question.
All right.
Motion get a second.
All right, so we have a motion to second. So the motion is to split the article into two portions. Do we need to have that ready again, or are we ready to vote?
Ready to vote.
Okay, so all those in favor of splitting Article 5 into the two portions as it is read to us, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no.
No.
We'll do it one more time. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no.
No.
All right, we're going to take this from my hand. We need two counters. I think we have divided them in halves. We need somebody for this side, somebody for this side. We have volunteers, Don Graney, and who else? Good.
I think we got two.
Okay. So let's do this first. All those in favor, raise your hand and keep your hand up until they point at you, okay? Yes, all those in favor, raise your hand.
Split it.
All those opposed to splitting the article, raise your hand. Only one hand.
Utilities and things like that. The bathrooms, we're looking at a minimal cost to get the two bathrooms in, and then the line painting and the street lights. Other than that, it will just be the ongoing maintenance every year too that will come out of that account.
If I could, I'd like to say it's probably dam over water, but the EPA or the DEP had come in as far as that boat ramp goes, and we needed to do some work to that boat ramp to come in compliance with them, and that was according to our road commissioner. So that's one thing we have to look at. It's going to be now or later. And I'd like everyone to realize that that project, as far as those sales, the sales of that sand, that project went on for 10 years. And when they proposed that project 10 years ago, there was a number put on that project. You take a project and you finish it 10 years later, that number grows. So, as Joe stated, it costs money over the years to do the project, but that project grew in time, and it, you know, inflation, et cetera, the number grows. So, I'd also like to say that the 380,000 boat ramp, we're going to try and do it in-house for 143. The number you people are working with is 143. The original proposal was 380.
170.
Well, 170, whatever. We're trying to do it in-house. So, is what I'm saying, we're trying to keep it in-house to keep the money down to get the project done. So, thank you.
Other discussion?
So what is the balance of the Mines Recreational Fund as of today?
As of October 22nd, we had a balance of $260,905. And that's the figure that Bill had mentioned earlier, that he did not want to use that to finish anything at the Pines. We need that as our kitty to maintain.
Other discussion?
Just so everybody knows, over the years, the town spends somewhere around $20,000 a year down at the Pines to do the maintenance on the fields. The softball people actually do a great job keeping the infield done, but every once in a while we have prescription turf come in. They slice seed the fields. I don't know if you remember back when they were dirt before we put irrigation in, but we spent about $50,000 back then to do that. The irrigation requires a pump to pump. The pump uses electricity. We spend the money on electricity. We have been spending the money on, I believe we bought a lawnmower in order to, you know, get the fields done faster, because all the groups wanted their fields done twice a week. We don't have enough people to do that. We're trying to get better equipment. So all the time we're spending money. Just realize that when that $260,000 is gone, you're gonna have to start charging field use permits. You know, the boat people are already paying a fee in order to get a key to use the boat ramp. People using the fields are eventually gonna have to help spend $20,000 or $30,000 to do the maintenance on these fields. So just realize we're at the fields, we're trying to get it all done. It's coming out pretty good. Kind of happy with the way it's going. The parking looks great. The boat ramp, when it's done, it's going to be hot top down to the concrete ramp. So no more washouts. Yearly, they go down there, they have to fill in the washouts. The light department goes down every year and takes the ramps in and out. They take in the docks. The people that, the Callahans, spent many years down there always getting the docks ready to go in, putting the coop and all or whatever it is to preserve them on it. So, I mean, there's been a lot of money spent, a lot of people's time. Softball, they put a lot of effort in down there. I've spent a lot of time down there on the Babe Ruth field. A lot of other people have too. So, you know, we're gonna get it done hopefully with this money. Need the support to do it. I believe that we can get it done. The estimates on the boat ramp, if we sent it out, is it $400,000 or $500,000?
Three, okay.
The highway department can do it for about 170. Years ago, we thought we could do it for 60. Obviously, those
should have been done.
Anyway, so if we had done it then, if we had the money, but we had to sell the dirt. So here we go, we're going to spend some more.
Any other discussion? I don't see anybody, so let's take a vote. All those in favor of Article 5 passing, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no. Majority, yes, and just that's our last article. But before we dissolve, I made one blue move, more than one, but when we started, Selectman Chairman Dunn asked me to read this, and I'm going to read it right now. Roland Pumpkin Fest 2015, show off your carving talent by participating in the first Roland Pumpkin Fest. Residents of all ages are encouraged to participate. Our pumpkin should be dropped off at Town Hall anytime before Thursday, October 29th at 6 p.m. The pumpkin lighting will take place on October 29th from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. So thank you. We need a motion to dissolve. We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
All in favor of dissolving special town meeting, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you.